It's Thursday, the 28th of July. It is just about 1:30 in the afternoon. I've just taken Oliver back to his mum's house. It's his birthday. We've had lunch, we had breakfast, and the scales were not particularly kind to me this morning, but then I didn't really expect them to be with all of the party food we had yesterday. I'm still a bit achy, and for some reason, I'm in an irrationally bad mood, but I can't figure out why. Nothing's gone wrong, everything's fine, but for some reason, I just don't seem to be able to snap out of it. So hopefully that'll clear by this afternoon. I need to take Nelly on a walk, and to add to the bad news, GoPro still haven't got back to me about the light mod replacement that they promised me I would get an email for on Monday or Tuesday. Obviously it's Thursday now, no sign of it, so I'm about to see if I can get another call back from them and find out what's going on. GoPro update. I waited a very long time for the call back. My phone rang once, then it went dead. And then I immediately got an email saying that my order has been shipped. So I guess they looked at the notes and thought there's no point in speaking to him. He just wants to make sure it's been shipped and then decided to actually ship it. So I've no idea when it's going to turn up. GoPro, I think, are located in Amsterdam. And according to them, when I spoke to them last time, shipping doesn't actually mean it's been posted. It means they've told their warehouse or logistics department to process it. So that can take 2 to 3 days, and then actually getting here could take longer. So I have no idea when it's going to turn up. I'm a little bit annoyed that no one bothered to ring me back, but at least something's happening. I've no idea how the audio of this one's going to come out because it's pretty windy. I've come out with Nelly. We're having a normal walk. The weather's gorgeous, but there is a very, very strong wind. But other than that, yeah, it's lovely. I've had a really lazy day today, though. I haven't done any exercise. This is the first walk I've come out with Nelly. My mood's improved, though. I don't feel as grumpy as I did before, which is nice. Well, I really wanted to just say that I'm a... Well, I apologise. It's not really my fault, but obviously I've caught up with the videos now in terms of what I've recorded and what you guys have seen. In fact, I just finished editing and uploading today's vlog that you'll be seeing as I'm recording this today, which was yesterday. And obviously with me doing shorter days because of the kids and whatnot and combining days together, that means there's going to be a few gaps in the future in between videos because, well, I can't record in the future, basically. So I either need to start recording more each day so that I can do single videos per day again, or I need to, we're just gonna have gaps, I guess. So that's all I wanted to say, really. Quick update on the bramble situation. They're all very much turning ripe now. It's nearly time for picking, which is good, although it does feel a bit early.
The ones over there,
where that guy and his dog are, they were all pretty much almost ready, but the big bushes, like these ones here, have still got quite a way to go yet, but they are all on the turn, so I think they'll be ready soon. GoPro battery update, by the way. We're going back quite a few videos now, but I don't know if you remember, but early on I was moaning about how bad the GoPro battery life was. I don't know whether I just got rubbish batteries with it or they were broken or what, but since I've put in these Enduro batteries, which technically aren't supposed to make much of a difference for normal day-to-day recording, they're really for colder weather, it lasts ages now. I hardly ever have to recharge it and I never have to swap the battery, which is absolutely brilliant. So yeah, it makes a big difference. The only thing other than the light mod that broke that I don't like about the GoPro is the sound. The microphone picks up okay when it's nice and quiet, and it's very clear when it's quiet, but there's so much processing goes on with the sound that it just, whenever there's any background noise or like rustling of paper or like when I'm cooking, it just pushes the volume up so much and it just sounds horrible. And it's quite tricky to work with, particularly like
if I turn the camera around like this, it only records from the front with this media mod.
So my voice just sounds awful unless it's pointing directly at me, which I guess is normal, but I don't really know what I can do about that. There is a mode on it just to like output the raw audio as a WAV file, but it's still slightly processed and it's so quiet you have to boost it right up in the whatever editor you're using, and you just get the same problem. So the only solution I've really got would be to wear like a wireless microphone, which I've got, but it's just a lot more faffing about, more batteries to charge, and you know, remembering to turn it on would probably be a bit of a hassle because you know, I often forget to turn the GoPro on. There's quite a lot of stuff that you've not seen because I've forgotten to press record, or I pressed it too early while the GoPro was still turning on and it didn't actually activate. So I don't know if I want all that extra hassle to do just to make these little vlogs. What do you think? Does it sound good enough? Does it sound all right? Let me know in the comments. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you're enjoying these, please. It's 7:15. I've eaten my dinner. I had the, well, that again, which was very nice. And now I'm just about ready for tonight's podcast. And tonight's podcast, we have something rather special. We have our first ever guest, Mr. Beardstone. So I'm very much looking forward to grilling him in the podcast. If you haven't seen the podcast, make sure to check them out. The links should be in the description below. They're really good fun. And if you're into Minecraft and all that sort of stuff, they might just be for you. Good morning. It is 6:20. It's Friday the 29th of July. I'm up early because I've got to edit the podcast today, and I need to edit it quickly because today Jack and I are going to see the new Thor film on the way to take him home. So we're leaving here around about 10 o'clock. I'm probably not going to be back until sort of 1 o'clock in the afternoon. So I've got a lot of work to do. On the scales this morning, there's actually almost zero improvement from yesterday, which isn't a bad thing. That means I didn't put any weight on yesterday, which is good because I didn't do a great deal of exercise. And apart from one injury that I had yesterday, which is quite painful today, everything's going okay. And the injury is not one you might expect. It's actually my tongue. I managed while I was eating my tea last night to bite the back of my tongue somehow, and now it's all swollen and it really hurts. So yeah, that one's not what I expected, but otherwise, yeah, feeling really good again, feeling energized, feeling happy. So right, I need to get on with this podcast though, so I better get cracking. And now at 4 p.m. in the afternoon, I'm finally home. It took a lot longer than I expected. The film started at 11:30 in the morning. By the time the trailers and everything had gone on, it was 12 o'clock. The film obviously went on for a good couple of hours, and by the time I got home, it was, well, nearly 3:30. So it's been a long one, which has resulted in me having done no exercise. I've not taken Nelly for a walk, but she has been out with her grandparents, so she's had a nice walk today. And also, my diet today has not been great. Because I knew I was going to the cinema and I wanted to enjoy it, I didn't have breakfast, and instead, when we got to the cinema, I got a small, although cinema small is pretty big, isn't it, salted popcorn to try, you know, not have anything that was full of sugar or anything like that. And then obviously I've missed lunch because we were there all that time. So when I got home, I've had my first Fusilli snack bar, and I'm going to hold out until it's time to cook something for tea and have something more decent and substantial for tea. So as a result, I'm not feeling quite as energetic as I was this morning, but obviously having hardly any decent food all day will probably do that to you. But I'm still, you know, I'm still feeling pretty great. Although I have to say, I don't think I can be bothered to do any exercise again today, but I really need to do it. Now, it's an absolutely gorgeous day outside today, so I think a bike ride would be a good idea. I just got to muster up the energy to actually be able to do it. I got this. I've been through heartaches, I've been to heaven. I've done my best and my worst, learned my lessons. No matter how hard my life would treat me, I'd always get right back up there. I feel according to Strava, I went 5.44 miles in 26 minutes at an average speed of 12.6 miles per hour. There was a 10.6 miles per hour wind against me for the first half, but fortunately it was my friend on the way back. And it wasn't too hard. It started off difficult, but that's probably because I haven't had much food and obviously the wind against me. But yeah, by the time I had the wind behind me, it was relatively easy and it was quite nice. Although it did just start raining a little bit near the end, but a little bit of rain doesn't hurt anyone and I quite enjoyed it. But now I really want to eat, so I think it's time for some food. For dinner, I'm going to be having my big juicy meatballs and pasta, which is what I cooked in week one. And the reason I'm cooking that is because my meatballs are going out of date today, so they need eating. And it's also ridiculously tasty, although it is quite a faff about actually cooking it. So it's going to be a while before I can eat it, but at least when I do, it'll taste amazing. And there we go. That doesn't look too bad. That looks pretty good. Let's eat.